Hello everybody, welcome to our channel Electrical Technology and Industrial Practice. So today we have come with another new topic. For more videos like this, please subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon to get the latest notifications. And please like our video, share our videos with your friend and comment if you have any doubt or if you want us to make video on any specific topic. So let's begin the video. So today our topic is transformer protection. Transformer is a very important equipment used in electrical power systems. It basically used to step up or step down the voltages and transfer the power. Suppose you are receiving power at 132 kV level, but you have to distribute it inside the plant at 11 kV level or 6.6 kV level, then you have to deploy 132 by 11.5 kV transformer or 132 by 6.9 kV transformer to reduce the voltage, step down the voltage and utilize it. Also, there is step up transformer which is used in power plant as generator transformer mainly. So I am not discussing much more about the transformer. Our topic is transformer protection. So we will see that how transformer is protected from different faults. Now, why transformer needs protection? Transformers need protection mainly against the following faults. Number one is phase fault. Number two, which is very important, is earth fault. And number three is transformer's internal troubles. I will explain what are the transformer internal troubles later. So now, what is phase fault? Phase fault is basically line to line fault or three phase fault. Okay, that means it is not related with the earth fault. No part of the conductor has been connected with the earth. It is a non-earth type fault. Okay, next is earth fault. Earth fault may be single line to earth fault or double line to earth fault. That is, one phase or two phase have been connected. Connected with the ground. And this is the most severe fault in transformer. So let's see why. Remember one thing, that earth fault could be very severe fault if there is any core material, which machines have core material? Transformer, generator and motor. These three machines have core material. That is, they transfer the electrical energy by means of magnetic field. So they need a core. Now the machines which have core material is very severe to earth fault. Why? Let us see. Core of the machines are connected to earth. Okay, remember that all core material of the of any machines are earth, and windings are wounded around the core. So if insulation of the innermost winding fails, then the conductor will be connected with the core, and since the core is connected with earth, it will cause a high resistance earth fault. Why high resistance? Because the core itself has high resistance. Moreover, the core is laminated and each laminations are separated by insulating material. So it will be very high resistance path, high resistance earth fault, and due to the presence of high resistance, the amount of earth fault current will be very low. But remember that this earth fault current may be low to determine, but may be adequate to damage the core. That is the major threat from the earth fault of any machine that have the core. Okay. Also, the percentage of winding where the fault has occurred plays an important role. Suppose if the fault has occurred at 100% of the winding, then obviously the 100% voltage will be delivering the fault current. But if the fault has occurred at say 10% of winding, then 10% voltage will be delivering the fault current. In that case, the earth fault current will be very low. So this low amount of earth fault current, why this is very dangerous? See, if the insulation has damaged and the earth fault current is passing through the core, then the core will be carrying the current, but the core is not designed for carrying the current, it is designed for carrying the magnetic field. So whenever it will carry current, it can create hot spot and it can lose its magnetic property. Okay, so that is why this type of machines are very severe when earth fault has occurred. See, this small amount of fault current may be inadequate to be detected but sufficient enough to damage the core. This is the major threat. Okay. Now, every machine that have core like transformer or generators, they have the fault current, earth fault current rating. Suppose a transformer is rated as 100 ampere for 10 second earth fault current. That means the core of the transformer could withstand 100 ampere for 1 second. So for that transformer, the system earth fault current should be restricted up to 100 ampere. Okay, so before installing any transformer or NGR system, neutral grounding system, we must ensure that what is the maximum earth fault current carrying capacity of the core, and we have to restrict the earth fault current within that capacity. Now we will see the protection diagram. Okay. So this is a typical protection diagram for LV transformer. Now what is LV transformer? LV transformer means basically which secondary voltage is 433 volt. Okay. No load secondary voltage is 433 volt, that is used for delivering 415 volt power. So I have connected here a delta star transformer. You can see that this is a circuit breaker which is connected, which is feeding the transformer, through which the transformer is getting fed. Now there is a 15P20, that is protection class PT, which is connected with the relay 50N and 51, and there is another CBCT, that is core balance CT. This is connected with 50G. Basically this is a sensitive earth fault relay. Apart from that, since this is a neutral connected transformer, so there will be one standby earth fault relay, that is 51NS, and there will be a restricted earth fault relay. Now I have made different separate video on restricted earth fault protection, you can check it. I am giving link in the description, also in the I button. And so these are the protection. Now all this protection will be fed to this circuit breaker. That means if any of the relay operates, it will trip this circuit breaker so that the fault is isolated. Okay. Now there are some transformer troubles relay. This is connected with the transformer. This is physically connected with the transformer, but inside the switchgear panel, there is a relay multiplier, that is there are some electromagnetic relay which multiplies the contact, and from there the trip signal is sent to the circuit breaker and the alarm signals are sent to annunciator. Now I will check what are the transformer troubles relays. So transformer trouble signals are Buchholz alarm, Buchholz trip. These two signals are generated by the Buchholz relay. Okay, so up to certain amount of gas generation, the Buchholz alarm raise, this alarm goes to the annunciator circuit, but if the range is higher than the set point, then it will cause the transformer feeder to trip. Okay, then there is WTI alarm, WTI trip. Now I am explaining what is WTI. After that there is OTI alarm, OTI trip, PRV alarm, PRV trip, and oil level gauge alarm. Generally these are the most common transformer trouble signals which is interchanged with the transformer feeders. Okay. Now we will check the protections for high voltage transformer. See, this is a high voltage transformer with OLTC. This arrow symbol is given used for OLTC. Remember this, that whenever there is no arrow symbol, this arrow symbol is not present, then the transformer is OCTC type, and if there is an arrow symbol, then the transformer should be of OLTC type. Okay, so here the basic protections are same as shown in the previous LT transformer diagram. Only one protection I have added here, that is transformer differential relay, which is differentially connected between the two end of the transformer. And apart from that, all the relay multiplier transformer relays are all are same. So since there is one OLTC, so for transformer troubles, all the troubles mentioned in the previous protection shall be as it is, but only there will be two additional signals, that is one is OLTC Buchholz alarm and OLTC Buchholz trip. So there are for the transformers having OLTC, there shall be two Buchholz relay. One is at transformer main tank and another is at OLTC. Apart from this, all the other signals are same. You can check it. Okay, so you can check that all the other signals, as I mentioned earlier, are same. Now, 50 is instantaneous overcurrent relay, 50N is instantaneous earth fault relay, 51 is IDMT overcurrent relay, 51NS is standby earth fault relay, 87T is transformer differential relay, 50G is sensitive earth fault relay, 64 is restricted earth fault relay. WTI stands for winding temperature index. It basically measures the temperature of the winding. Whenever it goes up to a certain set point, it raises the alarm. After that, it initiates the trip signal. Similarly, OTI stands for oil temperature index, and PRV stands for pressure release valve. Okay. Now 50 gives protection against the phase fault at high voltage side. Now why we are using instantaneous relay? See, a transformer is the end feeder of any certain voltage. Suppose you are using a 6.6 by 0.433 kV transformer. That means at 6.6 kV, that is the last feeder. After the other end of the transformer, you will get a new voltage level. So since this is the last feeder of a certain voltage level, the fault current also limits here. So you can use instantaneous relay, just like motor. Okay. Now we will go to our next topic, next point. 50N gives protection against the earth fault. 51 acts as the backup protection against the phase fault at LV side. I will explain it later with the help of the diagram. 64 is restricted earth fault protection. This is the primary earth fault protection for LV side. Remember this, that 64 is the fast actuating earth fault device. Okay. 51NS is inverse time relay, standby earth fault. It basically acts as the backup protection of the restricted earth fault protection. 87T gives protection against the internal phase fault. It is basically differential protection. 50G gives protection against more sensitive earth fault. Now I will explain one of its function one by one. First of all, suppose if any fault occurs at this point, at the high voltage side of the transformer, okay. If this is a phase fault, then this 50 will instantaneously operate and will isolate the fault. If that is earth fault, then this 50G will be first operated because it is connected with the CBCT, so it is more sensitive. The 50G will be operated, and if 50G doesn't operate, then this 50N will operate. Okay. Now, what is the functionality of the 51 relay? See, here at the LV side, suppose this is feeding any switch gear, it is feeding another LT switchboard. Okay, so here there is also 151 inverse time relay. Suppose any fault has occurred below that level, then this 51 will operate first. And due to fault at this LV side, reflection of the fault at LV side to HV side, this 51 will operate. That means if any fault has occurred at the LV side of the transformer, the 51 relay has failed to operate, then this HV side 51 will operate in coordination with the low voltage side 51. Okay. Now 64 is the primary restricted earth fault protection. This is the primary earth fault protection, but 64 is, since it is zone restricted, that means if these two CTs are connected here, So this 64 can only detect earth fault occurred before this city. Okay, that means where my mouse cursor is moving right now, up to this point this 64 can detect earth fault. If the earth fault has occurred at this point, then this 64 will not work. Then we have to go for this 51NS. Here the 51NS will give protection for that earth fault. Okay, so 64 is the primary earth fault protection at low voltage side, 51NS is the backup of that primary earth fault side. So you can see that here the transformer is protected by 4 number of earth fault protection. As I mentioned earlier, that earth fault is the most severe fault for this machines having core material. If you check my previous video of motor protection, you can see that there also we have used 2 number of motor protection relay, earth fault relay for motor protection. Here also for each voltage side, each winding, we have used 2 number of earth fault protection. One is the primary protection and another is its backup protection. Okay, so this is the basically your protection signals, and this transformer, all the transformer troubles are there. Now how these transformer troubles are taken care of, I am explaining now. All the transformer troubles shown here, the signals shown here, generates are basically an NO type contact. Okay, so these contacts are normally open type, but when the relay operated, this NO type contact converts into NC type contact. So at switchgear there are contact multipliers by means of electromagnetic relay. So this relay, these relays converts this contact into further number of contact. Now from there the trip signals are sent to the circuit breaker, and the alarm signals are sent to the annunciator, switchboard annunciator. So by this means the transformer protections are taken care of. Okay, I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have been able to learn something about the transformer protection, how the circuit is made, how the single line diagram is made. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please like, share with your friend, subscribe my channel, and comment if you have any suggestion to make my videos better, or if you want me to make video on any specific topic, I will try to make video on that. Many people has requested for transformer protection. Now today I am releasing this video, and I will try to make video on generator protection, and also I am planning to make video on some interesting electrical facts. Those will be very comprehensive type videos, very short video, but you will be able to learn many interesting fact about electrical engineering. Okay, so for today we are closing this. Stay healthy, stay good, and don't forget to subscribe my channel.